The creator of a global design agency founded in Marrakesh. He got his experience and background from Africa and Europe. His use of art ranges from the functional to the ecological and industrial. Please welcome Younes Dore.
Hello everyone. So yeah, I'm Younes Dore. I'm a product designer. I'm Moroccan. I live in Marrakech. My studio is in Marrakech. So I will show you my work, but this time I'm going to show you from another angle, and it's something more personal. So it's the first time I'm doing this. So it's difficult, but in the same time it's in English. So I'm not super good in English, as you can tell with my French accent. So. Perhaps you will have to help me finding some words I will lose during the presentation. Anyway, how it's going on actually when I receive a call or a message from the girls of Nukat. And this time it was Houssa who contacted me and say from WhatsApp, you know, and all these technology things, like saying like, Younes, I want you to come and do a lecture and a workshop. And me, I'm always like, yeah, I've got many ideas, I know exactly what I'm going to talk about, and the theme was about culture shock. But the truth is, I'm completely lost. It's like every time, you know, I want to, it's the truth, it's like I want to show to the Nukat that voilà. I know exactly that what I'm doing and I've got ideas, but actually I don't have any clue. When I hang up when I stop the message, when I hang up the phone, I'm always like, what I just did, you know, like, I have no idea, I don't know what I'm going to do. No, but that's really true. You know, it's like when you go to some, whatever, but it's like, you know, you are like completely lost. And the thing, it's like, it's really good exercise because it's, you know, I'm in my studio working in front of my computer, and I never had this chance to take a step back to look, you know, the things I'm doing, what I do and how I do it and why I do this kind of stuff. You know, you're in a rush of projects and you don't take time to really think about what you're doing. And sometimes, and that's why it's really nice and you have to continue doing this, it's like the opportunity of Nukat, it's really the time where I take a step back and I say, okay, let's think about it. So, the culture shock. And I wanted really to have like a presentation around this theme because I think it's an important theme. And because I had no clue and I had no ideas, the basic things I'm doing, because when I'm lost, I'm pretty basic. You know, I think about the school and its definition of terms. You know, like first, culture shock, let's define the terms. So culture, everyone knows what is a culture. It's about people, religion, language. And it's how you define culture, okay? This is the basic, it's what you find in Wikipedia and stuff like that. The shock is, I don't know, it's perhaps, there is different kind of definition of shock, but the one I like, I have this image in my head, always, you know, it's the atomic collision. And the effect of when two particles came together, and there is this collision, and there is this effect of energy going everywhere. But it's something violent. It's something that not only brings energy, like it's something really violent, really strong. And okay, I continue. So I put the two definitions together, and I have the culture shock. And there is something that makes me think about, because it's like there is this idea of the clash. Of the collision, what I just said, there is this idea of breaking, tearing apart. You know, it's like culture or two different kinds of material. You have the material A, which is the culture A. You have the material B, which is the culture B. It's like two kinds of rocks. And they smash together and suddenly it breaks. Everything goes everywhere. And it's violent, it's something violent. And for me, culture is not something material. It's not something physical. It's more polymorph. It's moving, it's changing. So when I start working on it and defining the terms and thinking about it, I was like, okay, I define the term. Let's now take an example. Because from that, we're going to take, for example, example. But for example, example. Yes. I don't want to see that on TV, on YouTube. You know, when you look back, you're like, oh, stupid. Never mind. And yeah. So taking example of two, because culture is about people. It's about family. It's about societies. So I say, okay, let's take two families, one French, one Moroccan, and let's see how the culture shock happens, where it happens. Simple. So the first family, Moroccan family, I choose this family because it's the typical, typical Moroccan family. The guy actually is someone really important in Morocco. He died, but he was somebody really important in Morocco. He was a Alem, a professor of theology in the first university in the world created by women in Fez. And he was a professor there. He fight for the independence of Morocco, but he fight without guns, without anything. Actually created school. The way for him to fight again and to get the independence was to create its school, because it say it's from school that you can fight the colonization. It's to teach the kids, because the kids are the future. So he started creating school against the French people who were in France. And he went to jail during 2 years, living in a box, completely in the dark. So it was something really strong. And he was one of the signature of the manifesto of independence of Morocco. And I love the woman behind. Please, look at that. I don't have to explain anything. She's beautiful. She's like, look, this picture was taken in 1917, the 70s. Look the position of the woman. Look how proud she is. Because he went to jail, the woman raised her child and all the family, everyone. So imagine how the power she needs to have and to use for the children, for everyone, because the man wasn't in the family. They were all in jail. So imagine how strong it was. But look, she has nothing, beautiful, she's smiling, she's, voilà. And she's even on top of the man. If you see, it's like there is, it's the woman, I mean. And the women in the independence of Morocco were really important, really, really important, because it was the link between people. So, voilà. First, Moroccan family, okay? Then, French. That's super French, huh? That's so French, I love that. And so the guy, but look, the story, it's amazing. The guy was an officer in the French army, and he fought the German during the First World War. And you remember, if I know in the history book, how strong and difficult this period was for Europe and for France. So he fought, he gets hurt, he had like a piece of metal inside of his hand, so sometimes he was going crazy, but it's true, huh? And after that, after the First World War, he went to war, but against Morocco, pacification. You know, it's the word they use, like, we do it for you, because you don't know how to be a pacifist. So we're gonna go and kill somebody, but c'est cool. It's part of the deal, huh? But again, look at the woman next to the guy. She's beautiful, she's wonderful, and she's like smiling, and voilà. So we have two different kind of families. But how can the culture shock be executed between those two families? Where we can see this culture shock? How we can see this culture shock? Imagine they fight against each other. I'm pretty sure they never see each other, but still, it's something, voilà, French words. And actually, I'm going to show you this picture. It was taken in 1980. So what you have to know, it's the woman on the right comes from the Moroccan family, and the man on the left, yes, comes from the French family. And they got married. So, this is a culture shock? Question mark. They get married, look happy they are. From those two different families, they're completely in opposite world. Do you see a culture shock first? Me, I don't see any culture shock there. Huh? They are super happy, there is musicians and stuff, it's cool. And you see the blonde, that, you think it's me? No, it's not me. It's my sister, because me, I was in the belly of my mother. And my mother is here today with us. And yeah, I agree with you, she's beautiful. Still now, Mama, you're beautiful. So, when you see this picture, do you really think there is a culture shock? 1980, can you tell there is a culture shock? Me, I don't want to use this term anymore. I don't want to speak about shock. I don't want to speak about the world that it's about violence and an opposition of two different entities. I want to speak about culture love. So I decided now that I will change the name of the new cat event and I will call it culture love.
Sorry, small request. Just be on the spot of the light.
I can't, man. I move. It's Africa, man. Africa. It's like we dance.
You're French now. You can use that maybe. That will help you.
No, okay. But thank no, man, never mind. We don't care, we care, we don't care. Well, no, I will.
It's for the cameras.
So, voilà, important to say. So, it's the idea. And the thing is like, okay, I come from those two families. You see how strong it is because it's like completely opposite. And I was raised in that. I was like raised in the story of the Moroccan independence. My mother told me that when she was young, and her mother asked her to take the milk to, you know, in the grocery shop. She saw dead bodies in the street, and she was like, you know, trying to get the milk in the hanout, and there are dead bodies. And so it's like, no, really, it's strong. When you're a kid and you are in France, raised in France, and you hear this story, it's something strong. It's something really, and in the same time, I was, you know, eating with my grandfather, talking to me about German fight. He went in jail by the German, came back by feet, 4,000 kilometers by feet.